makes you think they're going to be any more accepting of them Paris hemlines than Charleston was?
This is new country out here. Sweetwater just might appreciate European fashion.
Not on its new school teacher, they won't. Girl, you better let them skirts down and move them necklines up.
Don't worry, I will.
You better. You know what's good for you.
Don't worry, I will. I swear on my thimble.
Ladies.
Afternoon.
Heading to Sweetwater?
That's right. I'm going to be the new school teacher there.
I ain't never had no school mom pretty as you.
Doesn't sound like you've ever had a school mom.
Well, it's late. We better be moving on.
I expect you do. This ain't safe country for two ladies to be traveling alone.
Stop that. You stop that. That's my property.
Is that right?
Get your hands off of that!
Rob us! What's going on here?
None of your business.
He tried to rob us.
Maybe you ought to sit down or something.
Oh, it's all my fault. I should have never let them run away like that.
Horses get spooked. There's nothing anybody can do about it. Most women would have fainted dead away.
I'm not the fainting type, mister.
Oh, most folks just call me Kid.
Well, I'm indebted to you, Kid. My name is Samantha Edgars.
I'm just glad I was lucky enough to be here, Miss Edgars. Are you heading through to Sweetwater?
That's right. I'm the new school teacher.
Well, ain't that something? I mean, isn't that something?
Are you from Sweetwater?
Oh, you bet.
Then perhaps you could help us. You see, the new teaching job comes with a place to live, except I don't know where it is.
Oh, that'd be the old Miller place. It's just across town. I could lead you right there.
Oh, well, I wouldn't want to impose on you again.
I wouldn't be imposing. I got to ride by there anyway.
Well, if you're sure it isn't any trouble, Martha and I... Oh, my God, I forgot about Martha. I've got to go and get her. She's going to be worried sick.
Hold on. Let's take the wagon. I'll help you.
Chopped yourself enough wood to last all winter.
You think?
Mm-hmm. Maybe even through next winter. Gonna run out of trees pretty soon.
Something you wanted to talk about, Lou?
Thought maybe you did. Sometimes it helps to talk.
Really ain't much to talk about.
Kid used to do a lot of this when he was fretting over me. Looks like it's contagious. I know you ain't over that church lady you was courting, Alice. She was special. Probably won't ever forget her, but there'll be others.
Is that what you say about the kid? There'll be others?
I try to.
You believe it?
Sometimes. Sometimes love doesn't always make sense.
Love don't never make sense, if you ask me.
Guess it wouldn't be love if it did.
That?
I don't know. Looks like the kid then already staked his claim, though.
Snatching this place back from yesterday ain't gonna be easy.
Nope. But it'll be just fine when we're done.
Feels like you brung half of Charleston with you. How far'd you drive that wagon?
Oh, it was just from Blue Creek. We took the stage before then.
Why didn't you take it all the way?
Thank you for your help, but we don't want to keep you any longer.
Yes, I expect you have your work to get back to.
I reckon I better. You know, I'm mighty handy with a hammer. I'd be glad to help fix this place up.
That's very kind of you, but...
But we can't be thinking about any of that until we get ourselves settled.
Thank you. Well, I'm sure I'll be seeing you again.
I hope so.
You know better than this, Samantha.
Better than what?
Than turning the head of some boy who ain't got nothing but the clothes on his back. That ain't why we came here.
I know why we came here. I don't need reminding.
Don't hate me for wanting what's best for you. This is a new country out here, Samantha. Big and free as your dreams. All I want is to see you married to somebody worthy of you.
I never liked for suitors.
I ain't talking about someone who's just attracted to your beauty. There ain't no credit to the beautiful being beautiful. Though you are beautiful. It's the book learning and the breeding you done added to the looks God gave you. That's what'll matter to the man we want. So don't you be wasting your time looking at some poor boy like that.
I can look at whatever I want. I just can't have it, is all.
Come on, kid. We saw the way you were looking at her. I mean, your eyes were bigger than a lovesick cat.
You're crazy, Cody. I was helping her out, that's all.
Mm-hmm. Looked like more than helping going on to me.
So what's this new school teacher's name, anyhow?
Samantha.
See? You can't even say your name without flushing.
Yeah. Maybe you ought to give yourself some time to get over things.
Get over what? I mean, Lil, how long am I supposed to brood over something that just wasn't meant to be? Lil's sweet. She's good-hearted, but it just didn't work out. Maybe it never could have worked out the way we live and work together.
Lil!
A teaspoon? What is it?
I got a special ride for you, Lou. There's a shipment of bonds and bank drafts intended for Russell Majors and Waddell coming in from San Francisco. We got to pick it up at Willow Springs tomorrow morning. So you best put some miles behind you for Sunday. And I'm sending Jimmy with you.
I can handle it.
I didn't say you could. I just want a second gun on this one is all. You know, these two sure ain't turned out the way I thought they would.
Mm-hmm. How many times you been married, Teaspoon?
Just saddle up, will you?
Deliver your bag, sir.
You okay, Lou?
Kid was just talking, that's all. Fellas just seem to talk a lot. It don't mean anything, believe me.
Sure, that didn't mean nothing to him. Apparently nothing that happened between the two of us did.
That ain't what I meant.
I know. It's just that when the kid and I went our own separate ways, it was more my idea than his, and he's free to do what he wants. It hurts seeing him fall for another woman. He's probably thinking about her right now.
No, that's not true, Lou. Fool ain't thinking nothing at all. Go to sleep.
So you're saying we have to spend the night here?
Lou, the bank drafts were delayed. They should be here tomorrow. There's nothing more I can tell you.
Oh, that's just great.
What's the matter with him?
Oh, toothache.
See you later.
Yeah.
Everything. Just everything seems to be going wrong.
Oh, come on, Lou. I'd say this was a stroke of good fortune. Got the day off, all to ourselves. Beautiful sky, bright sun in Willow Springs.
There ain't nothing to do in Willow Springs.
No, no, I wouldn't say that. See what I mean?
Maybe your luck's changing already.
We'd like two rooms, please.
Only got one left.
Oh, mister, we had us a hell of a ride. You sure you ain't got a second one?
I said I ain't, and I ain't. That bed's big enough for both of you. Better grab it before it's gone.
We'll take the room.
Take the room.
can have the bed.
What is it?
Well, nothing, ye. Just look real beautiful, that's all.
Thank you. I'm going into town to order some books for my classes. I'll be back soon.
Well, I thought that we'd have a chance to talk.
We will later.
Well, I wanted to ask you something.
What?
The church is having a dance tonight. And I thought it'd be a good way for you to meet some of your students and their folks, kind of in an informal way. Now, anyway, if you wanted to go, I'd be happy to take you.
You attend church regularly, do you, kid?
I'd go every week if you were there.
Doesn't sound to me like you'd be thinking about spiritual matters much.
Usually a fellow only gets that kind of look from a girl's daddy. I guess she sort of feels like that, though, huh?
So what time will you come for me?
Tonight?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, about 6?
I'll be ready and looking forward to it.
I don't know what's so damn exciting about Willow Springs. There ain't nothing we can do here that we can't do back in Sweetwater.
No, I wouldn't be so sure about that, Lou. Just trust me.
Something I can do for you?
Well, it's Miss, actually. Miss Samantha Edgars. I'm the new school teacher. And you are?
Oh, Tompkins. Bill Tompkins. This is my store here.
Pleased to meet you.
Well, likewise. You know, folks around here have been expecting you.
Well, it's a pleasure to be here. Sweetwater is a lovely town.
Oh, yeah.
Now, there are a few things I'll need for my classes. A few books and art supplies that weren't part of the previous teacher's curriculum.
Well, I'll do the best I can to oblige.
And just what sort of art do you plan on teaching our children?
Only the finest, I'm sure. The seminal and the sublime. Sweetwater's most fortunate to have the minds of its children nourished by a light as bright as Miss Edgar.
This is unexpected, Robert.
You're looking lovely as ever, Samantha. Miss Edgar's teaching talents are well known to us in Charleston. I personally heard her praised highly by the head of the academy where she earned her teaching certificate. Sweetwater's gain is definitely our loss.
Well, you're very kind to say so, sir. Mr. Tompkins, I'll be back in a couple of weeks to see if those books have arrived.
Well, I'm afraid it'll be more like a month, Miss Edgars. This isn't Charleston.
No, it isn't. Good day to you.
Bye-bye.
If you'll excuse me.
You bet.
like I'm the envy of every man in Willow Springs.
Why, Samantha? Tell me. You disappear overnight, no explanation, no clue as to where you're headed. Does it amuse you to hurt me so?
No. Of course not, Robert. For God's sakes, don't think that.
Well, what should I think? How am I supposed to feel? Didn't you believe me when I said I want to marry you?
I told you that's impossible.
But you gave me no reason. Is it the difference in our ages? Because I don't believe that could truly keep us apart.
No, that is not it.
Well, then what? You owe me some explanation.
I told you I cannot marry you, Robert. I know that pains you, but I've made up my mind. And if you love me, you'll respect my decision.
Get up.
What is this stuff anyway?
Wine, they said.
I like it.
I can see that.
You ever think about the future? Where you'll be 5 years from now, 10? Where we'll all be?
No. No, I can't say that I do.
You're a funny man. Sweet man. You've been a good friend to me, Jimmy Hickok. It made me feel like a new woman.
Well, let's go. We got a fair to go to.
Thank you kindly.
How many times I got to say it? You're wasting your time and his.
It's our time to waste.
Why go to a dance with someone you know you can't take serious? Baby, you need to be looking friendly to these folks. Eligible. What are they going to think about a school teacher who picks up a boyfriend her first week in town?
I don't care.
You better care. You've got to care what these people think of you, Samantha. Your job depends on their respect.
I am sick and tired of pretending to be something I'm not. What's that Eliza we're going to tell Sweetwater? You think they'll buy the same brand we sold them in Charleston?
Samantha, calm down and listen to me.
No, you listen to me. Just when I thought I found the right man, someone who could take care of us.
He was too old for you.
Robert Andrews loved me. What difference did our ages make?
Andrews wasn't the one.
But why? Why?
You know why. Samantha, I was bought and sold in Charleston. If we moved there, it wouldn't have been long before they figured out what we are.
Robert would have accepted me for what I am.
Till you bore him a black child.
Don't you see, baby? If war comes and the South wins, the only way we're going to survive is if you pass for white.
I'm just so tired, Mom.
I know.
Beautiful volunteer.
Come on, go on.
All right, I will.
Let's give her a big hand, ladies and gentlemen. The volunteer to be the disappearing lady. Oh, wow.
I don't know, honestly, I don't know. Felix.
He's dead.
You look beautiful.
Thank you. I guess we're gonna see if you're as good on that dance floor as you're on a horse.
I think your toes are safe, trust me.
I do.
Well, shall we?
What is it?
Nothing.
Oh, no.
It looks worse than it is.
You did that work in here. You are not going to do another thing until these hands have healed.
Well, Samantha, the roof...
Never mind the roof. Now, you promise me or I am not going to give you a single dance.
Okay. Sorry.
Mr. Hickok, fella left a letter here for you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Marco.
I spy. Is that Rachel Dunn? Handsome couple, ain't they? May I have the honor, please?
With pleasure.
Like you could use a little refreshment.
Much obliged.
Excuse me. May I have the pleasure of this next dance?
Time to go, Samantha.
I'm not ready yet, Martha.
Yes, you are.
You heard the woman, Negro. Ah!
Martha!
What the hell are you doing?
I'm so sorry. Please forgive me. For God's sakes, why did you hit her?
My daddy owned her.
Here's the bill of sale, Marshal.
Lucky for Martha here, you keep it so handy.
Well, I've had to show it a lot since I've left Charleston, Marshal. Martha's mine.
Daddy owned her a long time ago.
A long time ago ain't now.
In fact, your daddy owned her don't mean you ever did. Martha, Miss Eggers here, has the right to file a complaint against him if you'd like.
I just want to go home.
Martha.
Please, Marshal, can't we leave now?
Well, you're free to do whatever you like. Andrews, just to set the record straight here officially, they may not want to press charges against you, but you ever touch her again, you'll wish you hadn't.
You know who he is, don't you?
Please just let it go.
Martha?
Robert, please leave us alone.
I just want to talk to her, Samantha.
It's okay. I'll be right there.
Lord, Martha, I swear I didn't recognize you at first.
I was just a Negro. Come between you and something you wanted.
I would never hurt you deliberately. You know that.
You let your father sell me, is all.
I tried to find you.
I was 40 miles away, Robert. 40 miles didn't put me on the edge of nowhere. Felt like it, though, sometimes.
How was I to know that?
No harm done, Massa. Big Daddy Drew just did what he had to do to keep the darkies in their place. And to keep you in yours.
I'll drive you home.
It'd be best if you didn't. Thank you anyway.
I'll be watching you, Andrews.
Well, you know.
That's right. If anything happens to those ladies in any way, you'll be damn sorry.
You threatening me, boy?
That's right, I am.
Well, I'm planning on seeing a good deal of those ladies, so, why don't we let the dawn decide?
Fine with me. But But dueling's done a little different out here.
Yeah, I've seen how you do it out here. Like dogs. But for a lady like Samantha, we ought to say this like gentlemen. You all gentlemen, aren't you? Two pistols each with a single shot. That suit you?
That's perfect.
Good. I look forward to it.
What are you doing?
Packing us up. We're moving on.
I am not going anywhere with you until you tell me why you deliberately ruined everything.
Oh, Samantha, there's so much of life you ain't never had to deal with.
And look what we've come to with you trying to protect me.
So now you know that man's father owned me years ago. He was a cruel master. He beat me bad and often. Except when Robert came between me and them blows. The good you see in him, I seen it too back then. And believe me, I needed it even more than you do now. I was just 15. We got close. Real close. When his father found out how we felt, he sold me off to someone else.
So now I know why you pulled me out of Charleston when you saw me with Robert. You were jealous.
Samantha, that ain't it.
That is it. You couldn't stand to see me with the man that you wanted, so you made me leave.
What?
And now you want me to do it all over again? Well, you can just forget it.
Samantha, that is not the...
One of those men is going to save me from the hell that you put me in, and I don't care which one it is anymore, you hear me? The heartache is going to stop right here, right now. And you are not going to get in my way, ever. Because I am not going to let you.
I appreciate your punctuality. Your lady friend and I were getting chilled.
You all right, Lou?
Yeah.
Oh, she's fine now. As you can see, her situation is somewhat tenuous.
Why the hell are you doing this?
Just returning the favor you did me.
It was a fair fight, Hopkins.
Gunfighting was my trade, and you took that away from me. You call that fair?
Lady's got nothing to do with it. Let her go.
No, I'm afraid I can't do that, Hickok. You see, I'm calling you out again, and this little lady is going to even the odds.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about you choosing between saving her or saving yourself. I'm going to shoot you, Hickok. Are you fast enough to drop me before I do? But your gunfire is going to spook this horse. By the time you reach her, she'll hang. Or you can shoot the horse. But if you do that, I'll have time enough to drop you assured. It's your choice.
Cut her loose. Face you with no guns.
Oh, that wouldn't be sport.
I ain't doing.
Pick it up.
I ain't gonna draw on you, Hopkins. Just want the lady.
Strap on your gun. Do it, Hickok!
You're gonna have to shoot me.
All right. My gunfire will spook this horse, and you both die.
It's all in that note from Mr. Robert. He wrote you in case something happened.
In case what happened?
I'm sorry, Miss Samantha. I ain't supposed to say
it. Hurry up!
What is it?
That's ready and loaded, sir.
It's a mighty beautiful gun.
Pardon me for saying so, but I never liked them.
I understand.
Let's get on with it. Explain the rules to him, will you?
We'll face each other from this distance. When you both have indicated to me that you're ready, I will say commence. Then you both may fire. Understand? Are you ready, gentlemen?
Way, Martha.
This won't solve anything, I tell you.
I'm in love with that woman, and I'm going to win her. I'll die trying.
You can't. She's your daughter.
You're lying.
I'm not. Just look at her. You know I'm telling you the truth.
Move, I put you both in jail. This duel is over.
Kid, I thought you knew better.
Robert, please call it off. I'll marry you, I promise.
I don't care what you are. I only care who you are.
Kid, I don't even know who I am.
Maybe I can help you find out.
It wouldn't be fair to either one of us. You see, I ran away from Robert, but I never stopped loving him. I just need a little more time before I can feel that way again.